locks vendors. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add products to your shop after your application has been approved. So simply visit oxybooks.com like this. Go to my account here and click login. So using the logins or the login details that we sent you, use the email address and your password that we sent you here, then click login. So after you've logged in, you come to a dashboard that looks like this one. This dashboard contains a lot of details, including customer questions, withdrawable balance available. You can withdraw your money using this section here. Then we have the dashboard, we have the store settings, we have product manager, coupons, statistics, stock reports, orders, payments, knowledge base, tools. So I'm particularly interested in showing you how to add new products. So as you can see, there's a tab already that's here where you can add your products from. So click on this tab, on this button, I mean, sorry. After you've done so, it will open something that looks like this. As you can see, we have a list of new products. Search for our existing product catalog. So in this case, we are particularly interested in listing a new product. So we're gonna come down here and click particularly on this, where we say create a new product. So I'm going to click here. Afterwards, you're gonna see the categories. So add a new product, add product, step one of two, select a product category. Once the category is assigned to a product, it cannot be altered. That's what it says. Then we have class notes, freelance guides, lecture notes, past papers. In fact, if you have a revision material and you find that it's not falling under the category of what is already listed here, you can contact the support team to add the new category, so that you are able to add a product that belongs to that particular category. For example, you have schemes of work, you have lesson plans and so on, and you wanna start selling them as ebook PDFs on this platform. You can notify the administration or the support team to add the new category. But what I'm interested about today is that, as you can see, the machine or the computer I'm using doesn't support the full functions of this dashboard. For example, when I try to click on class notes, nothing happens. I click again, nothing happens. Freelance, nothing happens. So if you experience the same problem like this one, which has been reported by about 90% of my Ox vendors or our Ox vendors, what you do, this is the front end of your dashboard. You can revert to the back end and add products from there. To do so, click on this button, black stuff here. It has a drop down menu. This is your profile management. So you click like this. It goes to, we have the storefront, we have profile management, we have WordPress backend, and we have logout. So I'm going to take you to the backend, because as you can see, the front end is inactive as of now due to my machine limited capabilities. So I'm going to click on WordPress backend. After you've done so, it will take you to the backend. As you can see, it's already been. And this is your dashboard now. It's Almost similar to the front end, but this one is somewhat basic, and but at the same time it is supported by every computer. So you can see you can add media, you go to your media library, maybe you have photos of your products or email product images, you can add new. We have all products add new. We have orders, you can check the orders that have been placed with you by your customers. You can add coupon codes up. The coupon codes will help you give your customers discounts. And we have sales reports. You can be checking your sales reports from this section here. And we have your profile. All these stuff, so I'm gonna create all videos that I explain how to use each of these. So in this case, and particularly in this video, I'm interested in adding a new product. So click on add new. When you add new, you can see there are so many details on this page. We have add new product, then we have a product name, then we have a paragraph. In this this section here, you wanna add your product description, then product categories. This one is very important. You have to choose a product category. If you are selling freelance guides, and that freelance guides belongs to academic writing, affiliate marketing and stuff and so on, you have to choose it. If it's blogging, if it's lecture notes, and it's Adventist University of Africa, Africa International University and so on, wherever you do, there's all these categories. Then we have product tags here. This is what is gonna notify search engines like Google on what type of product you are selling. I will show you how to add one. Then we have the product image. You can set product image from this point here. And if you wanna include a product gallery, you can add a product gallery images from this end. Then we have product data. This is very crucial, where you're gonna show people that this is downloadable. And if it is downloadable, then you don't need any shipping. Then you wanna mark all this, have the price, product short description. This one will appear on this short description side of your store. So I'm going to upload a sample, or I'm going to add a sample product, so that you're gonna understand particularly what I'm talking about. So in this case, I want to add English notes form one. So I will type English notes form one. So that's my product name. After doing so, it might want to bring some suggestions. So in this end, you are going to explain to your reader or to your customer why I have these notes, the importance, who can use them and so on. So for example, in this case, I'm going to write, this is a PDF format of English notes. English notes form one, available for instant download. Then you can say who can use this material. To do so, who can use this material, you can list, you say English teachers for classroom teaching purposes, form one English students, form one English students, even KCSE candidates who want to revise English notes from one. So in this case, you also need to tell your customer the importance of this, the importance of this material. the importance of this material like this. You want to tell your customers, you tell them this material is comprehensive and it contains well-crafted notes from one Kenyan syllabus. They contain everything that teachers should teach students, and you can say it is also a useful material for from one students and the KCSE candidates for revision purposes, in simple terms. So all the notes for Form 1 syllabus are put in one place and converted into PDF for easy access to students and teachers across Kenya. So when you have done this, ensure you proofread this PDF format of English notes from one available for instant download, English teachers for classroom teaching purposes and revision for from one students, KCSE can want to revise English notes from one. The importance of this material is comprehensive and contains well-crafted notes for Form 1 Kenyan syllabus. They contain everything that teachers should teach students. It's also a useful material for Form 1 students and the KCSE candidates for revision purposes, in simple terms. Okay, simply ensure in your description you give who can use the materials and what is the importance. That's what actually your customers needed to know, because there are so many people out here who are offering the same materials and the competition is very high. So you need to specify why your product is unique. So after doing so, I'm going to click on class notes. Like this, and another thing, what you should understand is that Ox eBooks is particularly focusing on advertising on the internet. You put your material on Ox eBooks, it gets indexed by Google, and when somebody searches such a keyword on Google, for example, Form 1, okay, English. Notes from one, like this. When you do so, you come here again and Google preview need to tell people, you need to also determine early enough how this stuff is gonna look on Google. You can check on a mobile result or on a desktop result. So in this case, you don't want to just show English notes from one. You also need, sorry. You also need to provide a meta description by editing the snippet below. So I will click on edit snippet. Here, I will write English notes from one in PDF format available for instant download and by teachers, by smart teachers and students. So when somebody searches for English notes from one, this is what will happen. English notes format in PDF format available for instant download by smart teachers. Always include this because this is very crucial. This is what will determine the number of sales that you're gonna make in this case. So it's very crucial. When you search on Google, it will bring all these results, and we want to be a search result number one. After you've done so, now go down to the product data. The product data provides the type of product you are selling, the price, the tax status and the tax class and so on. So in this case, these are downloadable PDF file. So you want to click on downloadable, then virtual, because these are virtual, you don't need to ship. So when you click on virtual, as you can see, we have shipping here, but when I click on virtual, the shipping stuff disappears. So because we are not doing any shipping, you wanna include, so you input your price, you put the price at 100 shillings. Sometimes you there's no need, just input the regular price only and deliver on the sell price. Downloadable files, add the file that like notes here. So you wanna upload the file from your computer, you come like that, and for me, I've already stored the file here, English ink notes form one in PDF. Always ensure it's in PDF format. So my material is uploading, it's a bit heavy. And I have to wait for a few seconds or even minutes. It's done. So after it's done, you can add insert file URL here. Click on this stuff down here like this. So you have already inserted the material that the customer is going to download after paying successfully. These other stuff, don't touch them, because according to our policy, all customers are eligible to unlimited downloads. So don't limit the number of times the customer can download the file from his account. Just leave it to be unlimited like that. So we have the product short description. In this section, you're going to tell the customer what this material is about. So this is, this material is a PDF version of English Notes Form 1 available for instant downloads. The material is comprehensive and fits for both teachers and doing students. So like that. So you inserted your product data, and you have provided the short description. So this is the long description here, and at the same time, in the long description, you can provide a preview of your notes. Sometimes you can add about a whole chapter here, so that the customer can really trust you that you did your selling the material. So KCSC, English notes form one, that's my product tag. I'm gonna tag them as English Notes Form one because that's what most people are searching on the internet. If you go to your browser and click English Notes, you'll see all these suggestions, and the suggestion that comes first is English Notes Form one. So I'm gonna use this tag. And then now set product image. This is very crucial. You must have an image for your product so that the customer is confident that you are indeed selling the material. So click on set product image and say upload files, select files. So I've already stored product image for English Notes. This is the one. And there's this type, there's this thing called alt text. This one here, you must add it using the product tag that you use. English notes from one. This is crucial so that when somebody searches for the same and clicks on images, you can see this image if it has already been indexed by Google. So set product image. So it's uploading, and for a moment it will be here. So that's the we have already put the product image. This is the one, and now I think everything is set. Ensure you insert everything required: the short description, the product data. You include your own price and stuff. You come, you add your product image. Also ensure the Google preview, how it's these notes are gonna appear on Google. You can add everything here as required. You add the product tag, you choose a category from this section here as required. Then after that, you can now check counter check. Everything is done. Now you need to submit for review. When you submit this product for review, it may take around less than 24 hours to be approved by the administration. The purpose of having a product review is to ensure that the product uploaded meets the standards of Ox eBooks. You have to upload original materials that respect the copyright laws and stuff. So if the product is your product submitted, the product, you can view your product from this end. So the customer will see something of this kind from their end. As you can see, feel free to look inside. Cheers from a notes, English notes from one. This material, this is the short description. It appears here. This one has already been put by the administration, explaining how to download the product. And you can see it's sold by Ben. If the customer send any problem with the product, maybe you have not put the file, but the customer has already paid, you can use that button to report abuse and so on. One more thing that I wish to state is that always ensure your customer money back guarantee. So go back to your short description down here and say money back guarantee. This motivates your customer to buy, because without a money back guarantee, nobody will trust you. So I will have my money back guarantee here. You can use this block quote and money back guarantee the way you may put it, and then you can again resubmit for review. So you can add as many products as you wish. Let me refresh this page and you can see money back guarantee. This is what I'm talking about. Yes, so you have already sent your product for review. It you can preview it, but it's not available for customers until the administration or the support team has approved it. So this is how you upload products for the first time to your dashboard, and this is how they will appear in front of the store. Thank you for watching. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to choose product tags carefully so that you make a good option. Thank you for watching.